And I hope you're all keeping safe and well.
And the next thing I want to do to the station before we start adding any brackets is to solidify the two buildings. What I mean by that is building a canopy from here to here. I was toying with the idea of having a lift-off canopy, but I don't think that is necessary in this case. So it'll be permanently fixed in situ. So I've got to work out a few dimensions and maybe make up another jig for this, because I'm still uncertain how I want to tackle it. I think the coffee stirring sticks may be a really good option for here. So let's have a look. Here we are, we're back at the bench, and I've been doing a lot of trial and errors, working out what would be best, the quickest way to put the canopy on to bridge those two buildings. I did think of coffee stirring sticks, but I'd have to make lots of individual pieces. Not only that, the coffee stirring sticks are not wide enough to allow a little step to sit on those supporting beams. So hence why I've made this template up to bridge the gap between the two beams. Let me explain. So the idea is to drop these supports by about 3 millimeters gap between the top of this apex to the canopy support, in order to allow a roof to come across. And as you can see, it fits nice and flush on the edges here, and that's what I'm after. So that was the rough template. So now we have proper support which misses the power feed bar, which goes from one side to the other, and I think that will work. So we'll have 6 of these running across from one side to another. So by taking these dimensions here, all I had to do was drop the apex down by 3 millimeters. So that should be 29 now. And obviously the angles stay the same. It's just that we're lowering the support. And all I have to do now is cut another 7 more of these. And once I've cut them, I will have to mark them 2 mil from the top to put in the supports, which will then run along the length of those supporting beams. So that is the plan. So whenever you're marking round templates, always make sure your pencil's nice and sharp, because the sizes could grow by the time you cut the last one. So that's for the apex. This will be for the support, this little piece here. So just make sure that we're flush with the bottom. Flush with the edges. And then mark out there, and that's ready for cutting. I have now cut out the apexes for the center roof, and I've also marked some lines as well. So I've come down from this edge 1.5 millimeters, which is the actual thickness of the card that I'm using here, and then marked it down from that tip there, 11.5, 22 millimeters, and then 8.5 right to that corner. And this will allow the card to tie in all of these apexes, like so, because card, piece of card this way and a piece of card that way, which will form a supporting ridge for the whole of the structure of this roof. That's the plan. And these offcuts I'm going to use to widen the wall so I can have some capping stones either side of the supporting center section of this roof, as you'll see. So the next thing to do now is to start cutting out all these pieces ready to take the card. And once you're happy with the distances from the tip of the apex to what you want to cut out and what you want to leave in there for the support of the windows, then we can start cutting. Making sure you take the pencil line off straight down the middle of the pencil line. Once you've cut them all out, you should end up with something like this. I have checked the distances between the two walls, and it is exactly 152 millimeters. And I have made this ridge, which will run right along the top of all six of these apexes. In order to make this ridge, I have measured piece of card 10.5, scored the line, and then from the center of that line gone this way again at 10.5, and then when it's folded from edge to corner, it works out roughly about 11 millimeters. Then the next thing we need to do is to check to make sure all our cutouts are perfectly fitting, making sure they're flush with the edge and they don't bunch up like this one does. So I'm going to have to take a little bit more off each one of them so it sits flat. And we do have a good one here that flits, sits nice and flat on the top and inside the cutout. So these are almost ready for gluing. Just got to check them all one last time, and then we can start assembling the roof section. So I'm using super glue for the two ends, just for quickness. And then once they're on, we can line up the rest of these apexes. I just want to get that flush and square with the cutouts. And just hold that for a while till the glue takes. Right, so that's the two ends done. And then what we'll do, we'll space out the other four every 28 millimeters. And I'll just use the rocket card glue for those. As you can see, it's beginning to take shape. And I'm onto one of the middle rafters now. And as I've been going along, I've been checking to see if they're square. But it's going to come to a stage where I'm just going to have to check by eye. So it's square that way. And it's square that way. And then just to make sure, I'll just put a tiny bit of super glue in each corner to hold it in place until rocket card glue takes a hold. But they do seem to be working out quite well, these joints. It's all now slowly coming together. All the apexes are glued to the ridge beam there, and I've also added one piece of card across the cutouts on the lower sections of these apexes, and I've just checked them and they're all 28 millimeters spacings, so that kind of works out quite well. And the last piece to do is to add this piece of card across there, and that will give it its strength, and then we'll give it a little test to see if it does fit in between those walls. We're just going to wait for that canopy to dry properly before we try and fit it into here. But in the meantime, those offcuts that were left over from the apexes, I'm going to start gluing them to the inside of these walls to give the walls that little bit of thickness that we're going to need for when we start putting the capping stones on. I have given this a try into the space between the two walls, and it does tend to buckle a little bit. So what I've done is I've put some super glue along this fascia here where it's a bit tight, and on here as well, and then sanded it, and it seems to sit on there properly. But what I've done also is to add a little bit more strength by putting some 28mm length of card in between each one of these rafters. So that's 3mm by 2mm card, just to add a bit of strength. And what I'm doing now to give a little bit more gluing surface is I'm adding some small bits of card along these feet, as it were, 5mm wide. And that will then give us a bit more gluing surface for the top of these beams, because it does want to buckle up a little bit. Not a lot, but a little bit. So by doing this, hopefully once it's glued onto these beams, it'll strengthen the whole area, as it were, between here and here. So I shall carry on doing that, and once I've done that, I will then paint the whole structure inside white, and that'll be ready for gluing onto these beams. Right, as you can see, I've added the bottom support there to give it a bit more rigidity. So now we shall try
Let's see if this canopy will actually fit in there without buckling. Right, it's in there. This side, the side you can't see, it seems to be sitting on there nicely, but this side there's a little bit of a bend in there, as you can see. But that can be pulled flat and held until the glue goes off. So I'm quite happy with that, even though I have sanded it even more to take another few thou off. So I think we're ready for gluing that into position after I have painted the underside, because you never know what camera angles, they always seem to show the unpainted edges. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to paint the whole of the inside of this in a satin white. I have now glued the canopy framework into its position, and I think that now has solidified the building. That's quite solid now, and before you can pick it up and you can feel it flexing in the middle. So now we need to check to see if it sits flat on the platform, so we shall have a look.
Yeah, so as I was saying, it has solidified the building, and I'm quite confident that I can pick the building up and put it down and take it over the benches much as I need to, because there's still a lot more work to do before it stays on the platform permanently, as it were. I was expecting a little bit more bounce than what I've got there, because obviously putting that in, I was expecting the buildings to have a small gap under here, but it seems to be sitting on the platform quite well, which is good. And so the next phase will be to, obviously there's another level of card to go on here, because I want to hide this joint, so there'll be another level of card and the glazing to go in, so we can actually be able to peer down through there and look at the people buying their tickets. So yeah, the roofs will be the next phase, and it'll be interesting to see how the two different pitches work, because obviously the slope on the canopy will be a little bit different to the slope coming down from the main roof. But I might want to add another row of bricks along there to bring the building out a fraction for the guttering, because I think we're going to see some of this brickwork after we've put on the roof. But it'd be interesting to see how that works out. And over here, I have already made a start on adding more card for the roof. As you can see there, I've got stuck a couple of bits of card there to support the roof when it comes over the lift and the maintenance door. We might not be able to see too much of the maintenance door, especially when we've got the roof on and the canopy coming out here, but that remains to be seen. So on the whole, I'm quite pleased with the way that has worked. I'm not sure what to do here yet. Maybe add some louvers or something to go through there, so if any smog or steam gets trapped underneath this canopy, you can always come out through the louvers. I'm not sure. It's things in the planning stage. So, I think that's enough for me waffling on. And, we'll see you again next time. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye for now. Bye.